Hello and welcome to my new video. Last time I have spoken about visualizing individual atoms, now we are talking about bonds between atoms. I will address only so-called covalent bonds, bonds caused by a common pair of electrons. Similar to single atoms, as illustrated in the last video, this common pair of electrons can be described as a standing wave of probability, the probability to encounter an electron at a given place. In this video, I will shortly talk about how these waves are formed, how they look like, and so on. First, however, I will repeat and widen the view on the unusual conditions when entering atomic dimensions. Actually, I think it is a crucial task for visualization of atoms and molecules to stress this point, to emphasize the fundamental differences between the world of atoms and our own macroscopic world. The main difference between our own world and the atomic world is wave-particle duality. So it means in our own world, we have a clear difference between particles on the one hand and waves on the other hand. They are two very different things. In the world of atoms, that's not the case. Everything has the properties of particles and the properties of waves at the same time. The lighter the things are, the more important this will become, and electrons are particularly light, and therefore these effects are particularly important for them. So here we have got two different models for the hydrogen atom. The first model on the left-hand side is from Niels Bohr many decades ago, and this is a rather conventional model. So it's a electron particle which is circling the proton in the center of this atom. And this model is even able to explain a number of properties of hydrogen atoms, but it is physically impossible because the electron would lose energy when it would really circle around the proton. So we have to find another model, and this alternative model is shown on the right-hand side. This electron here is constitutes a wave of probability to find the electron at a given location. And the denser this cloud here is depicted, the higher is the probability to actually find the electron at this place. Wave-particle duality has an interesting consequence for the energy of electrons, and this means for the energy of the whole system. And I want to shortly summarize this here. If you look at this picture, you see two hypothetical s orbitals of different size, so one is a bit larger than the other one. And at first hand, you might assume that the larger one has more energy because the median distance between the electron and the proton is larger, and therefore the electrostatic energy of the electron should be larger. But this is only one part of reality or of the thing. The other part is that the kinetic energy of the electron may be higher in this smaller orbital, and this is due to the uncertainty principle. The uncertainty principle states that the product of the uncertainty of the place and the uncertainty of the momentum of the electron is constant. And this means the smaller the radius of this orbital is, the higher the uncertainty of the momentum, and it means the higher the uncertainty of the kinetic energy may become. And by this way, this means that a smaller orbital with a lower amount of electrostatic energy might have a higher amount of kinetic energy. And again, so there is an optimum of the size of this s orbital, which has the lowest amount of energy. This is also important for larger molecules, because in the case of larger molecules, the orbitals are pretty large, so the electrons in these large orbitals are pretty slow because of this uncertainty principle, and this is one way how they can lose energy. Wave-particle duality, however, is not the only thing which distinguishes our own world from the atomic world. The forces which are shaping these two worlds are very different as well. Our own world is dominated by gravity and by mechanic interactions. The atomic world is dominated by electric fields, by positive and negative charges. Here the field of a positive charge of a proton is shown. It is strongly declining with increasing distance to the proton. On a positive charge, it has a repulsive effect, and on a negative charge, it has an attractive effect, so it is mirrored by the x-axis.
such fields actually are shaping the atomic environment. And I will come back how to visualize such fields later in the video. But first, I will speak about molecular orbitals and how to visualize those.
After this short summary of the unusual conditions in atomic dimensions, let's talk about how we can form orbitals of electron pairs shared by two atoms. Such orbitals can be obtained by combinations of geometrically suitable atomic orbitals occupied by two electrons in total, so ideally one electron in the case of each atom.
Okay, I've said molecular orbitals can be formed from atomic orbitals with suitable geometry and when each of these is occupied by one electron. And this would be such an example for a suitable geometry. So these would be two s orbitals from two different atoms, for example, two hydrogen atoms with their electron each in a 1s orbital, and the geometry of these two orbitals is fitting to each other, so they would be able to form a molecular orbital, and this orbital would look like this. Such a molecular orbital formed from two s-type orbitals or from two atomic orbitals with a geometry similar to s orbitals is called a sigma molecular orbital. It refers to a simple single bond, and it has the geometric characteristics as you can see on this picture here. Such a bond is only stable when this orbital is occupied by precisely two electrons. When there are more electrons, then anti-binding orbitals may be formed and the whole bond is no longer stable. So the two atoms which are to be combined, they have to possess two electrons which can be put into the new molecular orbital. Atomic s orbitals represent one type of geometry which can be used to form molecular orbitals. P orbitals represent the other type of geometry which can be used to form molecular orbitals. And in this case, the resulting orbital is called a p orbital and it looks like this. As in the case of sigma molecular orbitals, P molecular orbitals are not necessarily formed from atomic p orbitals. They may be formed also by all other orbitals which have a similar geometry as the p orbitals.
For really visualizing atoms or molecules, I think it is equally important to show the electric fields which are dominating these atoms and these molecules instead of only visualizing the electronic orbitals. And so this will be part of the next chapter and the last chapter of this video. The question, how can we visualize the electrical fields which are present in these atoms and which are dominating them?
Now that I have very shortly shown you the molecular orbitals and how they look like, let's come back to the electric fields and how we can visualize those. Here first I want to shortly recall the properties of electric fields, and there are two main properties we have to think about when trying to visualize. First of all, the electric force is strongly decreasing with the distance to the charge. And second, there are two different kinds of forces, attractive for the opposite charge and repulsive for the same charge. Can we visualize something like this? I would propose something very similar to the visualization of an atomic s orbital. So a cloud of dots with a high density in the very center and a strongly decreasing density to the outside. And then I would propose to use two different colors, orange for the positive charge and blue for the negative charge. And you only have to keep in mind that different colors are attracting each other and same colors are repulsing each other. This picture then would represent the visualization of the electric field of a proton. And this picture here would be the visualization of the field of an electron. So it's precisely the same visualization, only with a different color. We have just learned before, electrons are never standing still in the center of a coordinate system. They are always present as probability waves of a certain extension. And the question is, how can we visualize the electric field coming from such a probability wave? Actually, this is too difficult for me. So as a first approximation, I just take the very field of this hypothetical quiet electron in the center of the coordinate system. There's, of course, the danger to confuse these two visualizations, though, the visualization of the electric field and the visualization of the probability wave. So in this video from now on, I will only do visualization of electric fields. I will no longer do visualizations of probability waves. Just a short reminder how such fields are interacting. Fields of the same charge are repulsing each other, while fields of different charge are attracting each other, as is shown here. Now let's shortly come back to our hydrogen atom again. A neutral hydrogen atom, how would we visualize this one? We would just superimpose the field of the proton in orange color and the field of the electron in blue color. And as the main result, we will have a field of white color, so a neutral atom. This is, of course, pretty boring, but it becomes more interesting when we are looking at an activated hydrogen atom, which is still neutral, so there is no net charge in this case. But in the case when the electron is transferred to the p orbital, then we see that there are partial charges, though, that the positions around the equator of this atom is rather positively charged, while the positions around the northern or southern pole of this atom, they are rather negatively charged. In the case of sigma molecular orbitals, such visualizations, again, are pretty boring. They appear more or less white, so there is no polarity involved in such visualizations or in such molecular orbitals. But if you look at p orbitals, then again, as in the case of the atomic p orbital, you can see that there are regions in the molecule now which are rather positively charged, and there are other regions which are rather negatively charged. And this will become important when we come to certain kinds of molecules which have such p-molecular orbitals, and where you can look at reactivities of such molecules when looking at such visualizations.
So I think this is a good approach to visualize the electric potential in atoms or molecules. What do you think about it? I'm interested in your comments, so feel free to comment. We will get now to some compounds where this approach will give useful insight into behavior and the chemical behavior of these compounds. But first of all, I will talk about in the next video, I will talk about small molecules made of more than two atoms, or three or four or five atoms, and of the geometric arrangement of these atoms.